everybody, Mad Manga Girl 01 here, and I'm making a video of why I got into anime and manga, how it's important to me. Okay, so I probably was interested in anime and manga since I was a little kid, because when I was a kid, we went on a family vacation, apparently. Like, I didn't know this until, like, a year ago or something, and my dad says we go on a family vacation and there's like a giant con going on, and I'm like, what? And I'm of course already in otaku, so I'm like, oh holy crap, why didn't you tell me this kind of thing earlier? And he's like, oh well, I didn't think it would be important. Of course, me being like 3 years old, I'm looking at everybody dressed up in costumes and on all these colors and all these art styles and all these things just everyone fucking wear. Because when I was a kid, I always liked drawing and stuff, so I'm, like, looking everywhere, and my mom probably picked this up there, even though it says, it's for promotion, and she probably picks this up there, so when I'm, like, 6 years old, I'm, like, watching this, and I'm like, holy crap, this is so cool, you're obviously the moon princess, yada yada yada. I mean, of course, I didn't sound like that, but I don't fucking care. And then my parents went on vacation by themselves this time to San Fran on a business trip vacation thing for my mom's work. And they bring me home this. Of course, I don't read it until I'm 12, because I was such a faggot that I didn't like reading. And reading's fucking wonderful, so read a book. You know, so I read it, and I was like, holy crap. And then there's this article about Osamu Tezuka and Astro Boy, and I'm like, what the hell is that? Of course, I've already picked up Fruits Basket, which was my first lovely, lovely manga. I love you, Toru Honda. And so I start researching things. I had my own computer. I've had it since I was 7, and then I have this one now, which is great. I love you, Brian. So having that and having my own search engine on my own computer and stuff was really convenient. And you know, I could Google whatever I wanted. You know, yada yada yada. And so I got into it. And when I get into something, I pretty much get into it pretty hardcore. I see that this little box right here, this blue one that this thing is on top of, full of stickers. And then I just kept branching off, and I kept reading more, and I kept understanding more, and I went back and I understood things. And reading manga and anime, and watching anime, it helped me develop friendships. In middle school, I had no friends for the first 2 years, and then, I enter 8th grade, and I bring this with me to school for no reason. I mean, of course, I'm always worried that it's going to get damaged or something, so I wouldn't suggest bringing manga to school unless you like, reading, if you like exchanging or something. But, always brought it, and, yeah, in classes I would read it when everybody was, like, being mean to the teacher or something like that. Of course, one day, some girl just gets up and sits right in front of me and says, I'm going to sit here. And I was like, oh, okay. She tells me, apparently everybody thought I was mean because I sat there and I didn't talk to anybody. I had no idea. I thought I was just a quiet kid who was awkward. No, I was apparently the mean-looking child. And that was a shocker for me. So, of course, I'm like, oh, maybe I should be like Toru. And, you know, click into the whole being nice thing. Like, being open. Like, not always just, like, while you're staring at the board, not always be, like, just, like, making weird faces, then people would be like, what the fuck? I need to talk to you and find out what's wrong. And I took, you know, because I was really socially awkward. I didn't talk to anybody. I had a friend for a year, and then we got switched out of our classes together, and boom, friendship gone. It's sad. So then I find this, and I see all the emotions that are in this, and how people act, and I kind of mimic them in ways. I do the same. I'm gonna sit here with another girl. We're friends today. I do, like, oh god, now I have to sit in the back of the bus. Great. Some girl makes me sit with her. She looks at my folder, you know, drawings and whatnot, and she's like, oh my goodness, And, you know, I acted simply as I did, and because I was able to take these emotions and things from anime and manga and put them in my real life situation and make them work for me and how I develop things, and I still do things in real world today. If I'm in history class and my teacher starts talking about World War II or World War I, I'm gonna like go and I'm gonna think of Italia. Because that's, you know, that's, like, my connection to World War II and World War I and just, like, history and stuff. And it helps me understand things. When I go in chemistry class and I look at the periodic table, I will see GEOS. Because if it's in there, it's vague. GA and the S, and it's fun. And that's, you know, it helps me in my learning life, And, also, how it's important to me? It's so important to me. I don't really know what I would do if I never found Fruits Basket or Metropolis or Osamu Tezuka or Anime News Network or WatchCartoonsOnline.com or Crunchyroll or anything. If I didn't find that stuff, I mean, I'd pretty much be lost. If I didn't figure out that anime came on, at 12 o'clock at night on Sundays, Sunday morning, Saturday night, I wouldn't know what Bleach is, I wouldn't know what Kakashi is. I wouldn't know a lot of stuff. I wouldn't do Durarara, or FNA, B. it's kind of like, what would I do if I didn't know about that stuff? How would I, what would my art be like? How would I act around people? How would I nickname people? I mean, I nickname people a lot. Like, I don't have a nickname, which sucks. But, I mean, I nickname a lot of my friends. My friend Nicole and Nakio, my friend Laura, Laura? Lauren is Lauren? Yes. I wonder if they're gonna be mad at me for mentioning them in my videos. See, like, I can just, like, yes. I imagine things better. Like, everything is so much fun. When, if I'm in a good mood and I'm just, like, thinking about anime, I'll probably just, like, just break out laughing, because it just makes me so happy. I'm happy, and I'm joyful, and I think of things, and I, like, if that happens in a manga, it probably looks something like this. It helps my imagination, it helps me understand stories and concepts and how things work. I love it, and if you're one of those people who says, anime and manga's stupid, or anime's for losers, or anime's a cartoon. Like, that one will piss people off, so you shouldn't say that. But it's not anything different from what you love. It's just, it's not a cartoon, because a cartoon is like a Western thing, like Joni Test, Cartoon Network's Adventure Time, you know, regular show. Those are cartoons, yes. Anime is an advanced style. That things are bigger, they have storylines, they're powerful. It's something that people live on. And when I say this, I mean they draw it, and it gets printed, and people buy it. People use it to get over depressions and things, because manga and anime can do that. When I was reading Fruits Basket, I would look up the songs and listen to them for the anime. And I always read things like, oh my god, my mom just died, and I picked up this manga that really helped me. Just good stuff. It'll help you, and it's so great. Please don't hate on it. If you don't like it, then please don't say anything. If you can't get into it, then I'm sorry. That's sorry for you. And I suggest just trying it. So just try and make somebody watch it. I got a friend of mine, Laura, to watch it. And she likes it. She likes Fruits Basket. She's very excited. She's reading the manga as we speak, probably. Or she's sleeping. So anyway, in other news, I'm going to Orlando Anime Day on the 27th of this month. And if you're going, leave a comment below if you have similar experiences with anime or manga that helped you. Also leave that in the comments below. I'd like to hear somebody who had anime, manga, and people surrounding them help them develop in life and find out what they want to do when they're older. Like, I want to be a comic book artist now. Or a children's book artist. So, yeah. Tell me how anime manga has helped you, or tell me if you're going to an anime Orlando day. Whatever. Okay. Thanks for watching. Bye.